The euro crisis made Europe wake up to an important problem. Many countries share the euro as their common currency, but the country's banking systems are still organized nationally. The problem is known as a lack of banking union. Without a banking union, national governments and domestic banks are tied to each other. When one of them is considered less healthy, the other one gets infected. But a European banking union is in the works now. The main features have been agreed upon in December 2013. In the future, when a bank runs into trouble, a cascade of new measures kicks in. And these make it much less likely that national governments will have to step in. First, if a bank has to be wound down, shareholders and bondholders will be asked to foot the bill. This is called bail-in. And second, a European Resolution Fund will be formed. This fund steps in when bail-in is not enough to cover all losses. The fund will be financed by banks themselves. These two measures come on top of other changes, such as higher capital requirements that are already being phased in, living wills, in which banks describe how their essential functions can be continued when the bank is failing, and centralization of supervision at the European Central Bank. As the changes are many and profound, it will take a decade before the banking union is fully operational. But when it is, it should make the European financial system stronger and more resilient.